Well, thank you very much, Leslie, and I'm very happy to be here today to talk about the topic that is very much in the news these days and has been for decades, but we're hoping, actually, we may be actually about to see some real movement on the issue of immigration. And it's the topic of our discussion tonight and also of the forthcoming issue of Daedalus. It is something that Americans are quite ambivalent about. Americans have always been very warm towards immigrants when they think about their parents and their grandparents and their relatives and those their friends and their neighbors, and quite worried about immigrants when they think about them as someone different than they are. And right now, that ambivalence is firmly targeted towards our southern border, in which people are throughout America are really, I think we're seeing a new nativism that is quite virulent and quite disparaging towards immigrants from Latin America and most especially from Mexican Americans. And if you want to understand immigration policy and how it has gotten to the position that it's in and where it's going to go for in the future, you could not ask for anyone better than the two experts that we have here to speak with us tonight. Right now, many of us who study immigration are busy digesting the 800-page legislative proposal that's been put forth by the so-called Gang of Eight, the senators who have come together to put together this idea, that this proposal to fix our immigration policy. And that is to fix a policy which everyone agrees is broken, although there are many great disagreements about how it is broken and how to fix it. My own perspective is that right now we have 11 million undocumented people in the United States, and that's about the same number as the number of African Americans who lived under Jim Crow in the South prior to the Civil Rights Movement. These are people who have virtually no rights, and who live in the shadows, but yet are very much a part of our society. And perhaps the most poignant group are the group, the so-called dreamers, the people who have come since they were come as children, and who are highly assimilated Americans who face a cliff when they graduate from high school and realize that they can not find employment, not get a driver's license, not be a full adult in the only society in which they've ever known. There's also a very hidden, that most people don't know about, but very alarming rise in deportations that have occurred. It's been increasing under the Obama administration. 400,000 people deported yearly. People who are taken away from their families, some of whom don't speak the language of the country that they're going back to, and have no recourse, no legal recourse after they are deported. So we face a big mess, and hopefully tonight we're going to hear from the two experts on how we got here and how we might fix it. So I'm very happy that to introduce our two speakers tonight. Their full bios are in your program. First, let me say that Doug Massey is a sociologist who has studied racial segregation and immigration and American cities, and he has been the director of the Mexican Migration Project, which is one of the main ways that we know about what is actually happening with Mexican migration in the United States. He's the past president of the American Sociological Association, the Population Association of America, and the current president of the American Academy of Political and Social Science. And he's the author most recently of Brokered Boundaries, Constructing Immigration Identity in Anti-Immigrant Times, and Categorically Unequal, the American Stratification System. Jorge Castaneda is the Global Distinguished Professor of Politics and Latin American and Caribbean Studies at NYU. He is a political scientist, public intellectual, and prolific writer, and he has written a lot about Mexican society. He was the foreign minister of Mexico from 2000 to 2003, and in that position, he focused on diverse issues in U.S.-Mexican relations. And he is the author, most recently, of the book Ex-Mex, From Migrants to Immigrants. And he's a regular columnist for a number of different publications, including the Mexican Daily Reforma and Newsweek International. So I welcome our panelists up to the podium, and we will hear from Doug first.